All right, so good morning, good afternoon, good evening, everyone. Thanks for joining us from wherever you are. Today, we're going to share with you more into the better together integrations between Microsoft Defender for IoT and Microsoft Sentinel. This is Hisham Saad. I'm a senior security GBP in Microsoft and have my colleagues as well, Stefano and Daniel. They're going to join us today into presenting and sharing with you how we can do better together integrations between Defender for IoT and Microsoft Sentinel, and how it can help your SecOps and secure team to doing more aggregations, correlations across data from the OT, even enterprise IoT, extend to the IT perimeters. So let's get started. So our agenda today will cover main specific points. We'll give you a quick overview about what's Microsoft Defender for IoT and Microsoft Sentinel. And then we'll discuss more into the deployment model for Defender for IoT, covering different sensors options. And then we'll show you how to do integrations. Integrations between Defender for IoT and Sentinel from an alerts perspective, as well as from a raw data. But when you speak about the raw data ingestions, we will understand why and how we can do such kind of integration. And last but not least, we'll have a live demonstration showing you the integration model between Defender for IoT and Microsoft Sentinel, visualizing into a customized dashboard or a workbook. So if we start with the first item about an overview, what's Microsoft Sentinel? Microsoft Sentinel is the next generation of a SIEM solution. You can call it as an advanced security analytics platform because it's not just a kind of a next generation of a SIEM. It's providing a user entity behavior analytics UPA. It has an out-of-the-box built-in SOAR orchestrator for building custom playbooks, dashboards, workflows with a set of defined steps having actions and conditions, and a built-in threat intelligence hub for ingesting indicator of compromise feeds from any CTIs or even add your own TI indicators. So as you can see, Microsoft Sentinel providing a security analytics advanced platform from a collection phase of collecting any data from any data source, on-premise, hybrid cloud, or a pure cloud data, from a monitoring and detections, from a visibility enrichments with threat indicators, TI feeds, from an analytics behaviors running MLs and AI capabilities, huntings, going to investigations for incidents and case management. And last but not least, from an automations and respond from a triage perspective, using an automation set of rules, or even creating a custom playbooks based on a workflow. With the full integration with an API set, from an integration with community or a third-party data models. And then we're speaking about Microsoft Defender for IoT, which is a complete agentless secured solutions for unmanaged OT and IoT devices. It have a built-in native capabilities to doing an asset discovery, have a built-in capabilities from risk and vulnerability managements by identifying the vulnerabilities, the CVEs, the crown jewel assets, by having a continuous OT and IoT threat monitoring, creating alerts, incident response, and enrichment with TI threat intelligence feeds, operationals, as well as a unified security monitoring module. These are a quick overview into Microsoft Sentinel and Microsoft Defender for IoT solution. And then the next part, which is about the deployment model. So as you can see, Microsoft Defender for IoT provide multi-deployment options. If you have a complete air-gapped sites or a sensor, Microsoft Defender for IoT provide 100% on-premise sensor deployment model. You have your own local sensors deployed on on-prem in your network, and then starting to doing the all of the capabilities that we showed to you. Or even if you're a hybrid or even in clouds, Microsoft Defender for IoT provides such kind of a deployment model for integrating with cloud solutions, cloud SIM, data lakes, ITSM, ticketing, queuing systems, etc. And then we'll show it to you about how you will be able to integrate Microsoft Defender for IoT and Microsoft Sentinel. So the first level of integrations, which is related to alerts. And as you can see in the screen, if you go to your Microsoft Sentinel data connectors, you will be able to see there is a dedicated specific data connector called Microsoft Defender for IoT. And once you do the integrations, automatically Microsoft Sentinel will pull all of the alerts triggered by Defender for IoT and showing here into your Microsoft Sentinel instance. But what's interesting that our colleague Stefano will show it to you how, what would be the case if I would like to ingest raw data from Defender for IoT to Sentinel and how I'll be able to ingest it. So to you, Stefano, please.
Thanks a lot, Hesham. Happy to be here. So first of all, it's interesting to think about why it could be a good opportunity to ingest also raw data from the sensors. And well, there is a lot of information that we can bring from the sensor up to Sentinel just to do correlation and to have additional investigation there. So it's worth to have raw data taken from the sensor in many cases, because with the data connector that Hesham has just shown, we can have the alerts, but maybe this is not enough for our needs of correlation at SOC level. So basically, each sensor exposes a set of API, which gives detailed information about the devices which have been detected through network monitoring. We know that the sensor for Defender for IoT are connected to the network devices and expect the traffic and get those information. So we have the devices, we have the events that have been identified by monitoring this network traffic, and the alerts, which is related to those events. Finally, we have the vulnerabilities, so the CVEs and the vulnerable devices which have been detected. That's what we see in this high-level integration flow diagram. How to get those information within Sentinel? So basically, we can create a playbook, which is a logic app defined in Azure, and the playbook has shown in Sentinel. And this playbook is able to do HTTP requests to the endpoints exposed by the sensors. In our test implementation, the one that we are going to show now, we will see how those endpoints on the sensor can be exposed in a simple way. In our environment, is just a reverse proxy. But the architecture can be much more complex according to your security need. For example, you can deploy a data gateway on your internal network so that the connection from the logic app to the endpoint is much more protected. So it's a different architectural part that can be put in place. Okay. So take the control here of this window. We are in the home page of the sensor console, web console. And what I want to show you is that we have a device inventory, which is full of detailed information related to the sensors, to the devices, the IoT devices, which have been identified by the sensor that we are just accessing right now. And so we have a bunch of different information that it's worth to have to bring in our Sentinel workspace to do correlation and further investigation. Those details can be taken, as well as the alerts also can be taken. And for example, here we have a bunch of different information taken from a single alert. And we have all those events related to the entities connected to the alerts, as well as the event timeline related to those events which are relevant for this alert. So all of this is something, the event timeline can be seen at a higher level, not for a single alert. So all this is something that we can bring within our Sentinel workspace. And how to do this? For the first action is to generate a security token, which is a secure string that must be used in the playbook, so in the logic app, to call securely the endpoint of this sensor. This can be done here in the system settings. In under the integration, we have access token. And exactly here, we can generate, for example, a new token giving a name. And then just pushing the button generate will generate this new string, which can be just copied and pasted in the logic app. Hesham, to you to show the logic app.
Thanks,
from
Stefan.
This point.
Thank you. So Stefano showed to us that what's exactly needed as a prerequisite, which is a token that we needed to generate from the Defender for IoT to authenticate it mainly with how we'll be able to ingest and pull. And then Stefano, he shared with us as well, based on the high level logical flow, architecture flow, how, which kind of an APIs that we can leverage from the Defender for IoT side in order to invoke using this token to authenticate, and then we'll be able to pull this raw data. So let's show it to you how from the Microsoft Sentinel side. So when you go to the Microsoft Sentinel and go to the playbooks, you will be able to go to automation. You will see that there is a created custom Azure Logic app, which is a playbook here in the Microsoft Sentinel, which is a Microsoft Defender for IT get raw data. Once you click, and let's have a look exactly what's under the designer, which is step of flow of this specific data connector. So as you can see that we are setting a set of recurrence, it means that every specific internal frequency is starting to go and trigger and execute automatically this specific playbook. And then we're adding what we're calling a kind of variable. This variable can be a specific variable, which is having the Defender for IoT key token, or it can be even what we recommend to be as a kind of an Azure key vault. So you can create an Azure key vault, you can add the value of this Defender for IoT key token there, and then you will be able to call directly that Azure key vault value instead of having a string. So once you're having here, and here you can see that apart from the logic app or the playbook, we are using HTTP endpoint request. And you can see we have multiples one. We have one to get the even alerts if we'd like to not using the out-of-the-box connector. We can be able to get devices data, CVEs, vulnerabilities, events, vulnerable devices, security vulnerabilities, and operation vulnerabilities. So as you can see, let's have a look at one of these. If you're starting to open the HTTP endpoint, the method here is get, and then we're using the APIs related to the sensor. So here's the expose sensor, API v1 devices, giving the token based in header of authorization, content type to be rendered as a JSON format. And then once you're starting to run it, execute it, it will return a JSON output with all of the devices raw data being ingested from this Defender for IT sensor. And then the next step, what we need to be done is we'd like to iterate every single event or a device being returned, and then starting to save it to your Microsoft Sentinel workspace. So as you can see, we created like a for each iteration loop across the devices. We give it the body, which is represented the output coming from this HTTP endpoint, querying the devices data. And then we give it a table, custom table name, which is called Defender for IT underscore devices. Exactly the same you'll see it with CVEs, generating a custom log table, which is called Defender for IT CVE, the same for events, variables, vulnerabilities, security, etc. So this is a straightforward and a simple logic app created into Microsoft Sentinel that you will be able to invoke the Defender for IT APIs using the token to authenticate and then ingesting the data. But let's have a look at the result, exactly what will happen. So this means if you started to go to logs under the Microsoft Sentinel plate, and you started to see there are some custom logs table have been generated automatically based on the custom Defender for IT raw data being ingested. So let's have a look at how it looks like. Let's say I'd like to look at the devices raw data being ingested for the last 24 hours. When it started to run, I'll be able to see the result here showing me I having the time generated, the vendor, as in a kind of an example showing you here, show me the source system leveraging the REST APIs, what is a vendor, operating system, the MAC addresses, is the IPs, the name, type, authorization, scan, protocols, etc. Remember, what Stefano showed to you when you go to device inventory and open any kind of the metadata of the device, this is exactly how we'll be able to ingest it to Sentinel for doing aggregations and correlations with other data sources. And then I'm starting to look at the other set of tables, like show me the events that has been ingested from Defender for IoT for the last 24 hours. Here you go. So I'm seeing there is show me the title, severity, what is the type of operations of event being uploaded, downloaded, etc., and then showing the content. So if I go back a little bit to a couple of days in terms of events, and even if we have pretty much any kind of a data, you can easily using the summarize operator to summarize the set of tops. So I can go here and I would like to do a simple KQL Kusto query language, if you're familiar with Sentinel, and show me summarize all of the operations and type based on events that has been done for the last couple of days or a time range. So I can see set of operations from device update to upload to creations to connections to alerts, etc. You can do the same across the other set of a raw data in terms of even vulnerabilities. Show me even the CVE's vulnerabilities being triggered for the last 7 days from Defender for IoT. And as you can see, deep dive informations into the raw data. Show me the source, the IP, the CVEs itself, the scoring being done by Defender for IoT, the attack vector, descriptions, details about it. But the question is right now, we don't need to write such kind of queries. We would like to have a visualized dashboard or a workbook to show us not only the alerts, the raw data, and even to map it to the MITRE ICS framework in terms of TTPs and categories. So one of the out-of-the-box features coming with Sentinel, showing a deep integration between Microsoft Sentinel and Microsoft Defender for IoT, is a dedicated content hub or solution package. So when you go to the content hub and search for the IoT, you will see there is a dedicated threat monitoring solution package for Defender for IoT. You can get the description and you will be able to see there is a custom workbook or a dashboard being designed. So once we add it, actually, we would like to ingest and visualize this additional raw data to the same workbook. So once you deploy this content hub solution, you will be able to see under your My Workbooks, there is an IoT threat monitoring dashboard. And then when you click to open this specific workbook, we added a custom set of tabs. You will be able to see the alerts, the incidents, the MITRE attack for ICS industrial system mapping, even covering every single TTPs across the ICS MITRE, showing an additional sections like the OT device inventory, the sensor hands, and the vulnerability. And if you started to look at the OT devices inventory, this is actually invoking the data from the custom log table that we just ingested right now via the playbook. The same that's going to the vulnerabilities. I'd like to show all of the CVE's data and vulnerability shows the description, the attack vector, the scoring, and the CVE itself ID. These are pretty much data being ingested out of the box from the Defender for IoT raw database on the integration. This is a quick live demonstration showing you the value of the better together integration between Microsoft Defender for IoT and Microsoft Sentinel. We're showing you, giving you a quick overview, how it works. Our colleague Stefano showing you about the high level integration flow, design flow, how it'd be able to ingest the data from the APIs, how it looks like from the sensor itself, and we're showing to you even how it looks like into the Microsoft Sentinel. With that, thanks so much for your time and looking forward to join us later on the coming sessions.
Thank you.